Good morning, residents of Makati City. This is Archer's Eye for a special news report. Environmental issues that plague Makati City may be resolved as the city reveals information and ordinances that are aimed to reduce pollution. Reporting live from Makati City Hall, here's Miggy Angeles for a special report.
Thank you, Jago Rojas. I'm standing in front of Makati City Hall as a group of students interview councillors and environmental officers regarding the city's plan to be more environment friendly. Let's take a look at the highlights of these interviews.
As I've told you, I've done some browsing before you arrived. No? So I have here the 2011 annual report. And, part of the report is the how we spend our money. It says here, it's our comparative expenditure by service in billions of pesos. So for your main topic, which is the environment, it's 585 million.
What projects have you created lately with regards to environmental issues from Hati?
I was able to pass an ordinance that regulates the use of groundwater. The city of Makati's tabletop is at a critical low. So people tend to blame it on trash.
Irrigation.
The drainage system. But the truth of the matter is that our tabletop is sinking. No, and the culprit is our commercial establishments, our hotels. Instead of getting water from Maynila or Manila Water, which instead of that, they use groundwater.
Oh.
And because of that, we are encountering currently what we call as the land subsidence.
What are your initiatives for this year regarding the environment?
First, we have a lot of initiatives for solid waste management, and then we also have an array of initiatives for energy efficiency, and then we also have initiatives for urban green.
Could you give a few examples of some projects that you have already passed and perhaps their success rate so that people know?
We have received a lot of accolades on solid waste management given by the DENR and other national government agencies. For energy efficiency, actually, as what I've mentioned a while ago, we are currently conducting both our entity and community level greenhouse gas inventories. So in layman's term, we are trying to measure the emissions we have in the city so that we know with the results what projects we will be proposing to lessen the emissions we have in the city.
What measures are you doing in order to lessen these emissions from Makati?
Well, the primary recommendation based from the emissions is for us to plant more trees in the city. And since with the limited space in Makati, since all of us are in Makati, it's actually just what concrete already. So we have a lot of sister LGUs in Makati. So we are trying to plant more trees outside the local government unit. So maybe in one of our sister local government units, and then we can measure the carbon that is being captured based on the tree planting activities. Is one thing.
The regulation on plastics is very evident now. So I would like to ask you, what's your take on that?
Just for the information of everyone, we have already a pending Congress bill. For the regulation. I don't know if it's a banning or a regulation for the plastics in the whole Philippines. So Makati would actually is an advanced LGU, as we have been implementing this plastic regulation program since 2003 in accordance with our City Ordinance 2003-095. We are actually just regulating plastics in Makati. We're not banning. Because we don't want to hurt, again, I would like to point out, by banning plastics, you are hurting some economic an economic side. So there are a lot of people employed by the plastic industries. So we would like to be careful on how we would go about not these people not losing their job, but at the same time for us to effectively implement the plastic regulation program. So it's a regulation and it's not a banning. For all the students in La Salle Green Hills, maybe I would like to, in students in general, I would like to seek or encourage you to go green, or as what has been mentioned a while ago. But involve yourself. Involvement, I think, is the key. You are on your learning phase. I think it would be crucial for you to really do researches and maybe pursue a career in environment. So I think that would be a good start for a green environment. So isang makakalikasang pagbatid sa ating lahat. So
thank you very much.
It is good to know that our city has acknowledged the problems involving our environment. Back to you, Jacob.
Thank you, Biggie. We have some guest speakers to give us more info and ideas on the pressing environmental issues in Makati. Here's Josiah Talusa with our guest speakers.
Introducing renowned Dr. Ayer Zapanta and his colleagues, Ellie Malangit and Carl Wagner. Could you please discuss Makati City's role in the Philippines?
Since Makati City is the central business district of the Philippines, it attracts foreign and local investors.
It also attracts members of the working force who are looking for higher paying jobs in the Philippines.
What are the implications of this on Makati's environment?
There are several implications that come from this. One of these is overpopulation.
Makati's population is 600,000 at night.
But due to the overall number of workers coming here, this balloons to over 3 million people by day.
What other problems branch out from this?
Because of overpopulation, traffic becomes unbearable during the day.
A Japanese study states that we lose 2.4 billion pesos every day due to traffic.
And this also leads to air pollution.
And also to other kinds of pollution.
How did Makati address the flooding, especially near Marikaban Creek?
Marikaban Creek is the border of Pasay and Makati. This has caused floods for the past few decades.
Because of this, Barangay Magallanes has collaborated with the DPWH in an effort to rehabilitate the creek.
The average number of floods per year has dropped from 6 in 2010 to just 1 in 2012.
I've heard about the Green Urban Development Movement. Could you expound more on this program?
Basically, this is an education program for local barangays, orienting them in green ways on how to improve infrastructures.
Examples of these are vertical farming and the famous wall gardens.
Another example would be the beautification process of EDSA and Buendia.
A group of students have sent us a video on how the youth can help their city with environmental issues. Let's take a look.
I got soul, but I'm not a soldier.